everyone. This is a 1 hour gentle yoga practice. If you can, have an extra couple of pillows and a blanket to use as props, and then either a yoga mat or a blanket underneath you. We'll start lying down. So coming onto your back, finding any position that feels comfortable to start. Just getting comfortable, releasing down into the mat and into the floor. Breathing deeply. Allowing your mind to come into this moment and into this space that you've created for yoga. Giving yourself permission to let go of everything else for the next hour. Releasing any other thoughts or concerns that you might be carrying with you from earlier in the day. Just letting all of that go. Allowing your focus to come fully to the body and to the breath. Noticing how the body feels today, bringing your attention down to the toes and slowly drawing your awareness up the body. Just noting any sensations, any places that might feel stiff or tight. Noticing the places that feel relaxed and comfortable as well. Starting to deepen the breath. As you inhale, feeling the entire torso rise up toward the ceiling, lifting the belly as high as it can go. As you exhale, letting the belly and the chest both sink down. Again, as you inhale, feeling fully with air. Expanding as much as you possibly can with the breath. As you exhale, releasing down, sinking into the mat, and continuing with this deep breathing. If you have any intention that you'd like to set for your yoga practice today, doing that now. Starting to draw the arms up overhead, letting the backs of the hands come to the floor behind you, stretching the feet forward. Drawing the feet forward and drawing the hands back behind you, stretching as long as you can through the entire body, and then releasing, letting the elbows bend. And slowly walking the feet over to the top left corner of the mat and drawing the hands to the back left corner, coming into a crescent moon pose. As you inhale, drawing the breath from the left heel all the way up, from the right heel all the way up to the right fingertips. As you exhale, letting the breath flow back down to the feet. drawing the feet back to center and then bringing the head and the hands back to center as well. When you're ready, coming to your crescent moon stretch on the other side. Feet walk to the right corner of the mat and hands walk to the right corner of the mat as well. Inhaling up from the left heel to the left fingertips. Exhaling the breath down the length of the left side body. Back to center. Drawing the knees into the chest, bringing arms down to wrap around the shins and rocking from side to side over the spine. Hugging the right knee in, stretch the left leg long, bring some movement into both feet and ankle joints. And then changing the legs, hugging left knee in, stretching right leg long. Again, circling, bringing any kind of movement into the feet and ankles that feels good. Drawing the knees into the chest once more. And then bringing hands to the tops of the knees, circling, giving a nice massage to the low back and the hips here. Changing direction. And then circling the knees away from one another. Letting the knees come back to touch and slowly drawing soles of the feet down to the mat. Bringing the feet out as wide as the mat. And starting to windshield wiper the knees back and forth, letting them drop to one side and then to the other. And pausing the next time the knees come back to center, drawing them into the chest again, rocking back and forth over the spine. And rolling all the way onto the left side of the body, letting knees drop to the floor, stretching right arm out to the right, and bringing the focus back to the breath. Time you inhale, starting to draw yourself back up, rocking a couple of times side to side, and then coming onto the right side of the body, releasing the knees and stretching the left arm up. Slowly moving back to center, again rocking back and forth over the spine, releasing the soles of the feet down to the mat, crossing right ankle over left thigh, not overdoing it here at the beginning of the practice, so if you want to stay where you are, honoring that, if you feel like you need more of a stretch, you can bring the hands to the back of the left thigh and draw the legs in. changing the stretch, left ankle crosses over right thigh, and again, staying here if you'd like, or drawing the legs in. Releasing back down, stretching the whole body long again. Just relaxing here, taking a couple of deep breaths. Rolling over onto either side of the body, coming to a fetal pose, using the hand as a pillow. And just resting on the side, taking a breath or two here. And finding your way up to seated. Coming to sit in a cross-legged position, sitting up on a blanket or a pillow here, if that makes you more comfortable. Letting hands come down to the knees. Start by circling the head and neck, moving slowly in one direction and then the other. Letting the chin find its way to the chest. Interlacing fingers behind the head, adding a little gentle pressure and breathing into the back of the neck. On an exhale, releasing the hands down. Slowly rolling right ear up to right shoulder, bringing the right hand to the side of the head and stretching the left arm out, spreading the fingers wide. Inhaling up from the fingertips to the crown of the head. Exhaling the breath back down. Releasing tension each time you exhale. On an exhale, lowering the hands, circling chin to chest, and then drawing left ear up to left shoulder. Left hand comes to the side of the head, right arm stretches out. Again, inhaling from fingertips up to the top of the head. And on the exhale, releasing any tension or stress. Down, circling chin to chest, and just taking a couple circles, changing direction, and letting the head and neck come to neutral. And an inhale, lifting shoulders up to the ears, exhale, drawing them back and then down, inhaling shoulders up, and then exhaling back and down, inhaling again up, back and down, letting the shoulders fall naturally. Interlacing the fingers, pushing the palms out in front of you, reaching the arms up, taking a deep breath here. On an exhale, lowering the arms down, interlacing the fingers behind you and pulling them down toward the floor, drawing the chest open, lifting the chin here. And then on an exhale, release. Bringing the hands down to the floor in front of you, starting to walk the hands away and lowering the chest down, dropping the head, keeping hips rooted.
As you inhale, drawing the breath up from the hips to the shoulders. As you exhale, releasing any tension you might be holding in the back. Next time you inhale, walking the hands in and drawing the torso upright, we'll take a stretch over to the right, bringing the right hand down beside you, stretching the left arm out in line with the left ear, keeping that left hip rooted. If you need a deeper stretch, you can also drop the right elbow here, but making sure your hips can stay rooted. And finding the breath. Drawing yourself up to center, pausing for a moment here, noticing how the two sides of the body feel, and then stretching to the other side. Again, lowering the elbow if you'd like, keeping the right hip rooted, and finding your deep breath. Inhaling, lifting back up, pausing in center, and stretching once more to the right. Just taking one deep breath this time. Lifting back up and then stretching once more to the left. Coming back to center again, twisting over to the right. Left hand comes to right knee, stretching up tall through the spine. Releasing and twisting to the opposite side. Right hand comes to left knee. And coming back to center again, bringing hands to the knees, circling the chest forward and back, bringing as much of the body as you can into the movement, just ignoring my super old creaky floor. Changing the direction of the circle whenever you'd like, just making this movement your own. Letting this circle be your last. Drawing the arms out in front of you up to shoulder height, crossing right over left. And then either giving yourself a nice hug here, or if you'd like more of a stretch, drawing forearms together. Maybe even bringing the palms of the hands together if you can. Drawing the elbows up a little higher and breathing into the shoulders and the upper back. Exhale, releasing everything down, circling the shoulders a couple of times, and lifting the arms up again, this time crossing left over right, and coming into the same stretch again, either giving yourself a hug or bringing forearms together, lifting the elbows up. Lowering everything down, shaking out the shoulders and the arms, We'll move into table, coming onto hands and knees. Knees are below the hips and wrists are below the shoulders. Starting with cat-cow, on an inhale, lifting the tailbone up, drawing chest forward and up, lifting the chin. Exhale, rounding down and in, arching the back up. Inhale, lifting forward. And exhale, rounding and continuing to move at your own pace, letting the breath guide you as you feel yourself beginning to inhale, stretching into cow. And when you start to exhale, rounding to cat. Taking one more round of breath. After the next exhale is complete, coming back to a neutral table, turning the head to the left, looking back at the left hip, and drawing the left hip forward toward the head. Moving through center and turning to the right. Moving back through center again and to the left. And once more to the right. Coming back to center again, setting up for child's pose. Knees come out wider than the hips. Untucking the toes and draw the big toes toward one another. Sit the hips back toward the heels. If you can, lowering the elbows, dropping the head. You can feel free to use your pillows here, either under the head or under the hips or both, anything that makes you more comfortable. And if you have any tension in the wrists, settle, circling them out here. And just releasing down, we'll stay here for 5 breaths. On an inhale, lifting the head up off of the mat, looking forward, setting up to come into a downward facing dog, having hands shoulder width apart, spreading the fingers wide, planting down through all 4 corners of the palms, bending the elbows out towards the sides of the mat just a little, and then shifting up onto the knees, tucking the toes under, lifting the hips up, and pushing hips and thighs back toward the back of the mat, pushing the front of the mat away with the hands. Bending the right knee deeply, stretching left heel closer to the ground. And switching, bending left knee. Bending the right again. And then the left. And then stretching both heels at the same time toward the floor. On an inhale, starting to walk the feet forward, and we'll meet in a standing forward fold at the top of the mat, releasing the torso. Swaying gently from side to side here. You could also shake the head yes, shake the head no. Maybe grabbing hold of opposite elbows. On an inhale, coming up to flat back. And on an exhale, releasing down again. The next time you inhale, starting to slowly lift up to stand, taking your time to get there. Letting the arms sweep out beside you. And come to touch overhead, turning the gaze up to the ceiling. On an exhale, bringing hands down to heart center. And just pausing here for a breath, closing the eyes. Checking in with the body. Notice how everything feels. Checking in with your intention if you had one. arms released down by your sides, opening the eyes. Bringing the focus to the left foot, lifting it up and stepping back, coming to a high lunge. Coming onto the ball of the left foot and bending the right knee above the ankle. On an inhale, lifting the arms up, bending the elbows out to the side so you can create space between the shoulders and the ears, and breathing into the left hip. The next time you exhale, dropping your arms down by your sides, bringing the focus to the left foot, rotating it in about 45 degrees and dropping the left heel down. And bringing your focus to the right foot and heel toeing it in so that the heel of the right foot is in line with the center of the left foot. Setting up for warrior two here, bending the right knee again, lifting the arms up to shoulder height, and then turning your gaze over, looking out across the right fingertips. Lowering the arms down, straightening the front leg. We'll set up for a triangle pose. So lifting the arms up again as if you're coming into warrior two, but this time imagine that your right fingertips are being pulled forward, lengthening as much as you can. And then when you've lengthened as much as you can, dropping the hand down first to the thigh, stretching left fingertips up to the ceiling. If you feel like you can go deeper without hunching forward through the upper body, then lowering the hand. If you lower the hand and you start to kind of hunch forward, bringing the hand back up so you can stay straight through the upper body. And turning the gaze wherever is most comfortable for the neck. And focusing on the breath. The next inhale, starting to lift your torso back upright, bending the right knee again. And we'll take one more stretch on this side, coming into side angle, lifting arms up again to shoulder height. This time bending the right elbow 90 degrees, fingertips point forward, and then just tipping yourself forward, dropping that forearm onto the thigh, and stretching the left ear up in line. Stretching the left arm up in line with the left ear. Inhaling up from the left heel to the left fingertips, expanding through the left side of the body. And drawing the right knee toward the right side of the mat. One more breath in side angle, and as you inhale, drawing back up, releasing the arms, straightening the front leg, turning the right foot in, having both feet face forward. We'll come to a wide-legged forward fold here. If you'd like to have a prop to place the hands on, grabbing something, either a stack of books or a chair, just pausing and grabbing that prop now for yourself. And when you're ready, hinging from the hips, slowly lowering down, bringing your hands either to the floor or to your prop, having a slight bend in the knees so you're not hyperextending, drawing the crown of the head toward the floor. Finding a quality of release here, even if there's a lot of sensation present in the pose. Releasing down through the entire torso, through the head, through the neck, letting any tension go.
Taking one more deep breath here. Releasing as fully as you can on the exhale. As you inhale, starting to slowly draw the torso back up. When you come up, rolling the shoulders up and back. Bringing the focus to the left foot. Turning the left toes out to the opposite side of the mat. Coming onto the ball of the right foot. And coming in to a high lunge. Fingertips stretch up to the ceiling. Breathing into the right hip. Lowering the arms down, bringing the focus to the right foot, heel to the ground, and kind of shimmying the left foot in a little so that the left heel is in line with the center of the right foot. Arms come up to warrior two, and turning the gaze out over the left fingertips. And exhale, dropping the arms down, straightening the front leg, lifting arms up once again, and stretching forward as far as you can, letting the hand come down first to the thigh, right fingertips up to the ceiling. If you can go further, feel free, but again, trying not to round the back. One more breath here in triangle. On your next inhale, lifting back up. Once again, bending the right knee, setting up for side angle pose, arms come up to shoulder height, bending the left elbow, drawing the fingertips forward, and then dropping down, releasing left forearm to the thigh, right arm stretches up in line with left ear. Next inhale, lifting back up, turning the left toes in, and heel-toeing both feet, or if you're using a blanket, just stepping the feet into the center. We'll take a balancing pose here, coming up onto the ball of the right foot, and just propping that right foot up against the left ankle, staying here if you'd like. You can also bring the right foot against the calf or against the thigh, drawing the hands together at your heart. And finding a fixed point for your gaze to help you balance. Keeping the arms at heart center or lifting them up and out if you prefer. Taking one more breath here in tree. And releasing, shaking everything out. Coming to the other side, up onto the ball of the left foot, propping it against the ankle or the calf or the thigh. Anywhere except right against the knee, which will be a little too much pressure for the knee. Hands come together, heart center. Option to also lift the arms up and out. And finding the breath. Last breath, releasing. Coming to the top of the mat again, on an inhale, sweeping the arms up, turning the gaze to look up at the hands. On an exhale, hinging from the hips, folding down, releasing everything. Inhaling up to a flat back. And exhaling back down, bringing the hands onto the mat. Stepping one foot back and then the other.
Lifting up to a downward facing dog. Taking a couple of breaths here. And then dropping dropping the knees down, coming into child's knees, come out wider than the hips. Untucking the feet, drawing big toes toward one another. Sitting the hips back. And we'll stay here for 5 breaths, releasing. If it's more comfortable, you can also bring the hands back next to the feet. Bringing your focus fully back to the body here, if it's wandered at all. Back to the breath. Releasing into the mat and letting everything else go. Your next inhale, starting to slowly lift the torso up, coming to sit on the heels, and then drop the hips over to one side, bringing the legs out in front of you, and drawing the soles of the feet together, sitting up tall or leaning forward, finding the position that works best for you here, and breathing into the stretch. Inhale, lifting the torso back upright, bringing the hands to the outsides of the knees, drawing them together, stretching left leg long, and then crossing the right leg over, hugging it with the left arm, and bringing the right hand beside you on an inhale, or behind you on an inhale, lifting tall, and an exhale, twisting. Uncurling and releasing the right leg down alongside the left, shaking the legs out, bending the left knee, crossing it over right, hugging the right arm around the leg, and planting the left palm behind you. As you plant the left palm down, using that leverage to draw the crown of the head up a little higher. Releasing, bringing the left leg down alongside the right, scooting the hips forward to the center of your mat, and we'll come down onto the back. Crossing right ankle over left thigh, drawing the legs in. Exhale, lowering both feet back down to the mat, crossing left ankle over right thigh, and drawing the legs into the chest. Lowering both feet back down to the mat, stretching the legs long, Lifting the arms up overhead, stretching the entire body again. And then relaxing, letting everything release down into the mat. Inhaling the breath up from the toes to the crown of the head, filling the entire body with air. And exhale, releasing the breath back down to the feet. Drawing knees into the chest, bringing the arms down to wrap around the shins, rocking side to side. Hugging right knee in, stretching left long. And slowly drawing the right knee over to the left, rolling yourself all the way to the left side of the body, drawing right knee toward the floor, and stretching right arm out to the right, turning the gaze over to the right as well. Inhale, start to lift the right knee back up, rolling onto the back, stretching the right leg long, hugging left knee in, and starting to roll over to the right. Left arm extends. Lifting back up, coming onto the back, releasing the left leg down alongside the right, and then drawing both knees into the chest, rocking side to side over the spine. And releasing the legs down. And sitting up for just a moment, we'll set up for a restorative pose before our final resting pose. So grabbing any props that you have and we'll bring some height underneath the chest. So you can just use a pillow here and place it under the chest to have a little bit of elevation. If you want more, you can use two pillows. You can also use your folded blanket. And then if you want something for the head, you can either just have nothing under the head, or if you prefer, placing a blanket or pillow underneath the head here. And then letting the arms fall out to the sides, letting the legs come out long. If you'd like more of an inner thigh and hip stretch and it feels comfortable enough for you, you could also bring the soles of the feet together. That's just an option. I'm resting here for a few minutes, getting comfortable, just releasing down, sinking into the props, letting them support you. to slowly find your way off of the props, maybe rolling over to the side. And just moving the props out of your way. And we'll set up for our final resting pose. If you want to pause and take any extra movements, stretches, poses first, you can feel free to do that. When you're ready for the final resting pose, take your blanket if you have one, and just folding it the long way, we'll put the blanket underneath the knees. And if you'd like, you can also use a pillow under the head or arranging the props in any other way that feels good for your body. And just coming down to your resting pose, letting yourself release into the mat, turning the palms up toward the ceiling, taking a deep breath, sighing out on the exhale, letting everything go, giving yourself permission to be fully present for the next few minutes with the body and with the breath, releasing anything else. The breath, and don't worry about trying to change the breath at all. Just letting your mind follow the movement of the inhale as it flows into the body, following the movement of the exhale as you breathe out. And letting this subtle movement of the breath draw the mind into a place of inner consistency and calm. Resting the mind here for the next few minutes. To bring some subtle movement into the fingers and the toes, moving the hands and the feet. When you're ready, finding your way into a fetal pose, rolling onto either side of the body, and just resting there for a couple of breaths. Slowly lifting yourself up to seated. Coming to sit with legs crossed. Keeping the eyes closed for another moment. Drawing the hands together in front of the heart. Taking another deep breath in. And exhaling. And as you start to bring the focus back to your surroundings and start to bring the body back into motion, holding on to the sense of stillness and peace from the yoga practice. With a bow, thank you for joining, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.